What's poppin', everybody? It's your boy, Dark Animation, back with another video. Today we'll be taking a look at Overwatch 2, the long-awaited sequel. I'll be giving my thoughts and opinions on both Overwatch and Overwatch 2. Without further ado, let's get into the video. Overwatch is getting a sequel, and this time we're doing story mode, which the first one lacked. This was something that a lot of fans were disappointed about. We got amazing lore, but had to read the comic books or watch the animated shorts on YouTube in order to access it. This was a bad decision on Blizzard's part because players shouldn't have to seek an outside source to learn additional information about the characters in the game. Overwatch was still an amazing game nonetheless. This time not only will we get to watch the action, but we'll experience firsthand. Although we did have some fun limited time PvE modes such as Junkenstein's Revenge, Uprising, etc. This is good for players who might not enjoy PvP as much, but still love the story behind the game. Some people believe that Overwatch 2 is pointless, since all multiplayer content will be available on both the first and second game. However, I feel like this is an amazing move on Blizzard's part because it will feel refreshing, guys. Overwatch has been out for over 3 years now, and it will probably be out by 4 by the time Overwatch 2 is released. And there are going to be changes to PvP in Overwatch 2, such as character skill trees, that could drastically change the way the game is played. And some people prefer the classic playstyle. Also, I know that Blizzard could just add PvE to the current Overwatch, but it's known for being a PvP game with the occasional PvE content. And honestly, I think it should remain that way if you ask me. I spent a lot of time grinding Overwatch, climbing the ranks until finally hitting the Master Division. I'm positive I could have gone higher, but shortly after hitting Master, I stopped playing. I had a good 75 days played, though, and I'm certain I'll have more on the next. That's if I don't run into the same problems that made me give up on Overwatch in the first place. Naturally, as time passed, the game became repetitive and I found myself playing something different, but it was a game I could always go back to. But there were other factors that caused me to deviate from the game. The main one was a problem that I noticed many others had as well. I'm a console player and I use controllers, so it's very frustrating running into the occasional mouse and keyboard player. Some people argue that it's rare, but I've always been a high diamond, low master player, and I run into them more often than you would think. Blizzard even stated that they would prefer people not use mouse and keyboard on the console, but admitted that there's nothing they, you know, could possibly do, since it's nearly impossible to tell when someone is using it. And they clearly just can't ban everyone who gets reported, because a lot of people make false claims because they're upset they got beat by a skill controller user, little babies. I myself have been accused of mouse and keyboard on more than one occasion. It's cheating no matter how you look at it. It takes the fun away from the game for people playing fairly. Why use a mouse and keyboard on console anyway? Because those players are actually garbage and can't compete against other mouse and keyboard users on PC. So they play against controller users to lessen the competition. And don't leave a comment saying, I should use a mouse and keyboard, because I shouldn't have to change my playstyle for a way that's meant to be played on console. Throwers and competitive were also a huge problem. Blizzard did somewhat combat this by adding the LFG system in the game, but that allows people to choose their character preference, but everyone knows that LFG can be toxic and sometimes you just want to be in solo queue. In order to play competitive in Overwatch, you must at least be account level 25. While this is nice so new players with little to no experience can't just jump straight into comp, it doesn't change the fact that they could just have been running the character or class the entire time and then choose any character they want in comp. Players should have to be a certain level with a character or complete certain requirements with that character before they can access them in the competitive playlist. Smurf accounts should also be banned. If the hours spent playing doesn't match with the rank on the account, then it shouldn't immediately be banned. People trying to make their way out of gold or plat shouldn't be forced to play against diamond and master skilled players. The announcement for Overwatch 2 was made in November. And I'm just dropping this video now because I already had a couple video ideas planned and halfway completed during that time. So I'm sorry, guys. I only upload once a week for now because of my busy schedule. But don't worry, because I have a lot of fun ideas planned for next month. If you made it to the end, then thank you. Make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends, aunties, daddies, grannies, whoever the case may be. Also, hit that bell so you'll be notified every time I release a new video, baby. I love you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace out.